Hey Huskies, I'm Raquel Blackburn, and you're watching your Socially Distanced Hills Report.
I'm Mark McFarland, and we're here once again to give you a brief news and announcements for this new year.
The library is open now for checkout and exchange. It will be open at 1:30 to 3:30. School pictures also need to be picked up from the student store as soon as possible. Open weekdays between 1 and 2:45.
Senior athletes, are you committed to playing a sport in college? Do you have a national letter of intent? If so, please email Linda McMillan or Millen in the Athletes Center. Regarding our National Signing Day acknowledgement.
For those of you planning on attending college in the fall, complete your FAFSA by March 2nd. Most colleges require this to offer you a financial aid package. Once again, head to the Career Center webpage for links.
Huskies. Our school wants you... Huskies. Our school wants you to know they care about your mental health. Look out for the anonymous mental health survey in your Google Classroom all this week. Please be honest. We want to hear from you.
All right, with those announcements wrapped up, let's head into our first segment.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to another What's Trending. Joe Biden has been inaugurated into office, and he's officially the 46th U.S. president. We congratulate him and wish him for the best. The movie Boogie has released a trailer in which they have the post-hominous acting debut of Pop Smoke. The movie looks really interesting, and if you're wanting to look at the trailer, go ahead and watch it on YouTube. Apex Legends new season is fastly approaching us, in which they revealed the new character Fuse and showed his backstory. If you're wanting to look at the trailer yourself, go ahead and check it out on YouTube. That was What's Trending, guys. Thank you for watching, and see you guys again next week.
Wow, a new year and a whole new president. Things are changing so quickly in 2021.
Absolutely. I mean, I hope they do after 2020. Anyways, let's get into our new segment, Fun Facts.
Hey Eskies, I'm Yusuf Alawadi, and welcome back to another Fun Facts video. It's Earth Edition, and let's get started. Okay, question number one. What is the moon made out of? And the answer is, the moon is made out of rock and metal, just like the Earth, and the other rocky planets, Mercury, Venus, and Mars. The crust, the moon's outer shell is covered by lunar soil, also called regolith, a blanket of fine rock particles. Question number two. What is the largest planet in the solar system? And the answer is Jupiter, the biggest. Question number three. What is the hottest planet in the solar system? And the answer is Mercury. It's the smallest and the hottest. Question number four. What planet is closest in size to Earth? And the answer is Venus. Question number five. What is the third planet from the sun? And the answer is Earth. It's the sweater I'm wearing for it. Yay. Okay, Huskies. This time for question six, it's a true or false. So, for six, Neptune is larger than Saturn. And your answer is false. Question number 7. The chemical element uranium was named after what planet? And the answer is Uranus. Question number 8. What planet is nicknamed the Red Planet? The answer is Mars. And it's true, it is red. Question number 9. What is the 7th planet from the sun? And the answer is Uranus. Question number 10. What is the brightest planet in the night sky? And the answer is Jupiter. Question number 11. What are the main colors of planet Earth? Okay, the answers are blue, green, and white for Antarctica. Question number 12. What is on planet Earth? Okay, answers are, it consists of land, air, water, and life. The land contains mountains, valleys, and flat areas. The air is made up of different gases, mainly nitrogen and oxygen. The water includes oceans, lakes, rivers, streams, rain, snow, and ice. For the final question, Huskies, which is question number 13. What is the most dangerous planet in the solar system? And the answer is Venus. And, why? Venus is the most dangerous planet in the solar system. Its surface is at 393 Celsius, hot enough to melt lead. It's even hotter than the planet Mercury, which is closest to the sun. Venus's atmosphere is acidic and thick. So, warning, you cannot go there. Not me too. And that's it, Huskies. Thanks for watching this week's Fun Facts, Earth Edition. And I will see you guys later. And I'm gonna go look outside. So come on, let's go.
Yes, so much we've yet to discover. But all this chatting is making me hungry.
We've got a perfect segment for that. Let's head into it.
Hi, Huskies. My name is Sydney Bowie, and in this episode of Quarantine Cuisine, we are going to be making creamy pesto shrimp Alfredo. Hope you enjoy.
These are the ingredients and the measurements needed to cook this dish, so don't be lazy, and please read them. The first step whenever you are cooking a meal is to always wash your hands thoroughly. Make sure you wash for at least 50 seconds with soap. First things first, you gotta fill up a large pot with water and place it on the stove on high heat for the water to boil. While the water is boiling, you are going to take your grape tomatoes and cut them in half, like Victoria is doing here. Then you are going to take the cloves of garlic and finely mince them so there are no chunks of garlic in your pasta. Once you have everything all chopped up, you're going to want to take your half and half in pesto and pour it into a medium-sized bowl. The pesto we use looks a little weird because we had to use two different kinds of pesto, but once those are added together, you want to mix them together so they are thoroughly combined. By this time, the water should be already boiled and you need to add a box of linguine noodles to your water to cook. Make sure you stir it once in a while so the noodles don't get stuck to the bottom of the pot. Once the noodles have cooked for about 9 minutes, you want to take the pot off the heat and drain the noodles. You can leave the noodles in the strainer for now. We will come back to them at a later time. Moving on, you are going to want to grab a pretty big pan and melt some butter in it. Once the butter is melted, add your grape tomatoes, shrimp, and garlic to the pan. If you want to season the shrimp a little bit, you can add a little salt and pepper as well. You're going to leave this to simmer for a little to cook the shrimp and make the tomatoes a little squishy. While it is cooking a little, take a wooden spoon and mix everything together. Make sure you don't leave it unattended though, otherwise it will burn, ruining the meal, so be careful. After the shrimp is a little cooked, you're going to add the half and half pesto mix and the Parmesan cheese. Again, you're going to want to let this simmer for a little bit while constantly stirring to combine everything. The final actual cooking step is to add your linguine that you cooked previously to your Alfredo sauce. You want to make sure all the pasta is coated in the sauce, so be sure to mix thoroughly. And the last and final step to do is to serve it. So make sure you have a nice plate and put a good serving of your creation on the plate. And that's how you make creamy pesto shrimp Alfredo. Hope you enjoyed.
Wow, that looks delicious and I'm starving.
Doesn't look too tough to whip up either.
That's a wrap for today's episode, so on that note, make sure you subscribe down below and turn on notifications bell for more weekly videos. Most importantly, make sure to be safe, respectful, responsible, and have fun.
And as always, Huskies, let's stay #HuskyStrong.
Adios.